Hi, good afternoon all. This is Ashok Vomara. Welcome to my YouTube channel. So I'm the full-time trader and trainer. So the today concept is, does your trading strategy will works 90% of accuracy? So based on strategy, trading strategy accuracy, so I am going to discuss in this video. Okay, so end of this video, you came to know, so how much percentage work for any trading strategy. Okay, before going to this video, kindly pause the video and read the disclaimer. Now we'll start with this subject. Okay, so coming to this, five things you should know before the entry. So this is based on reality, not just oral like that. Okay, so what are the things is required going to entry? What are the checklist you need going to take the trade? First one is the entry. Entry is very most important based on the strategy you are entering. Okay, and second is the stop loss. Third is the target. Fourth is the risk management. And the most important thing is the fifth is the trading psychology. Okay, let's start with this strategy. So this strategy is open strategy. So I am going to tell this strategy is most of the times it works very well and high returns you will be get by using this strategy. So first, if first 5 minutes candle closes above previous day high level, this is the first 5 minutes candle. It closes above previous day high level. This is the previous day high. So then you got a long opportunity. So this is the entry. And what is the stop loss for this? Stop loss means is the protection of your trade. So that is the decided protection. Okay. So in this case, stop loss would be the below previous day high. So that means you are protecting previous day high. Your trade protecting previous day high. Sometimes very rare chances, some spike will come, hit your stop losses and go upside. Okay, so that cases, if you put the stop losses below the candle, so you are having two protections. One is the previous day high, second is the first 5 minutes candle. Okay, if it is candle very small, then you can, this cases, you can put the stop losses below the previous candle low. Or if you're having any pivot bands below this previous day high level, so then you can put below that pivot level. So you'll be get two protections for your trade. So entry decided and stop loss decided and target. What is the target? Target is, so how much your stop loss based on that two times of your reward. So that means you are putting the stop loss of 40 points. So your target should be the 80 points. Okay. In this 80 points, from entry to up to 80 points, up to 2 hour. Okay. So in between, if it is not having any pivots, weekly pivots or daily pivots or any supply zones, then you can go with the strategy. So this is works well. If it is not having any strong barriers in between, if it is any pivot around this level in between, so don't go for the opportunity. So wait for the retracement. Once you got that price action at this previous day high, supporting at previous day high, that cases you can go for the long. So this is for long opportunity. And this strategy will work downside also. If it is first 5 minutes candle closes below the previous day low level, first 5 minutes candle, this is the previous day low. If it is closes below the previous day low level, then you can go for the short. Stop loss is the above the previous day low or above the first 5 minutes candle high. And you check any pivot above the previous day low. So you'll be get double protection of your stop loss. So this is the strategy. So now we are discussing entry, stop loss and target. What are the two things? Two major things is, next is the risk management. So risk management is the holy grail in trading. So how it is holy grail, I am going to explain about this chart. Okay, so for example, if you having 1 lakh of capital, okay, so you are decided to risk per trade is 1% and reward per trade is 2%. So that means 1000 rupees of risk and 2000 of reward. Okay, so if you calculate 20 trades in a month, and if it is worst scenario, 50% of the win rate. So 10 trades win, 10 trades lost. So that means 20,000 you gain and 10,000 you lost. But final outcome will come 10,000 rupees of profit. So this is 10% of your capital. And this is a worst scenario. Try to understand. And if it is 60% of win rate, 12 trades, that means 24,000 rupees of profit, and 8 trades of lost, and that's 8,000 rupees. The final outcome will come 16,000 rupees. That means 16% of your capital. Or if it is 70% win rate, this is a high probable trades. Okay, 70% is high rate win rate, and 14 trades are win 28,000, 6 trades are lost 6,000, final outcome with 22,000. So that means 22% of your capital. So that's the reason I am saying risk management is the holy grail in trading, not for the strategies. Okay, so as of now we have discussed entry, stop loss, target and risk management. The final most important is the trading psychology. Trading psychology is very, very important. I'm going to explain three scenarios. Okay. 50% of the success depending on your trading psychology. So I'm going to explain three scenarios. Okay. Most of the traders initial stage, this is going to happen. So I'm going to discuss about these scenarios. Okay. Scenario one. For example, Bank Nifty trading at 35,000. Okay. Same examples I am taken for these three scenarios. So you can easy to understand. Okay. So Bank Nifty trading at 35,000 rupees. Entry, you got the entry 35,000 rupees and 40 rupees of stop loss. That means 34,960. Target would be the 34,080 rupees. This is the 2R. Okay. Once you enter the trade, prices went to up to 35,050. And after that, if you see any bearish candle, the traders saw bearish candle. So once you see the bearish candle, trader is fear and exited the trade at 35,030. So by fear is exited the trade. So he got only 30 rupees of 30 points of profit. That means 750. And that day prices went to up to 35,300. Now he is thinking, so I could have wait for the end of the day. I could have get more profits. This is a 7,500 rupees of profit, but I exited with only 750. Because of fear, he has exited the trade. And next day, same trader, I'm taking the same calculation for easy to understand, right? Scenario two, he has took the trade 35,000. And stop loss is the same 34,960. Now he has put the target is 35,080. Okay. So prices went his direction. Once price went to up to 35,060 level. Okay. He is thinking that yesterday I missed the 300 points of opportunity. So I remove the target and wait for at least I would have get at least 200 points of profit like yesterday. He is thinking and is removed the target. Prices went to up to 35,100 and after that sudden fall will come and prices hit the stop loss 34,960. And prices came 34,950 and bounces and it closes end of the day with 35,150. This is a scenario two. Now, what is thinking that? Yesterday, I missed the 300 points opportunity. That's the reason today I have not exited the trade at the target. Once you reach my target, So I am not exit the trade. So this is not going to work. Okay. And third day, next day, I am going to maintain 40 rupees of stop loss, 80 rupees of the target. Next day, same he has taken, this values are taken the same because of easy to understand. And next day, scenario three, he has entered the same price, 35,000, stop loss is 34,960 and target would be the 35,080. He said put the target and stop loss and everything. After some time, prices came to 34,980 and 970 level. Now he is thinking, again he is thinking. He is thinking, so yesterday prices came to 34,950. My stop loss is 960. So I am changing my stop loss to 34,930. It's a 20 points buffer of the stop loss. He has changed the stop loss 34,930. Prices came 34,950 and 940. So anyway, yesterday and day before yesterday, moment will be there. 200 to 300 points moment will be there. Okay. So now I'm changing to stop loss 34,900. Again, he has take the another 30 points of risk. Okay. Now his stop loss become 100 points. After some consolidation, is break the stop losses and hit the stop losses. Now is more emotion. Okay. And so anyway, market is going to short only. Market is selling side. So yes, thinking that market is in selling side. So I will take two lots of 34,900. I each shorted two lots of 34,900 and put the stop loss of 34,950. So prices came 34,850 or 860 that level. Again, he has bounced and again hit the stop losses. Now he is double emotional. He lost control the emotion. So again, this loss will be 5,000. Already 5,000 loss is there. Now he is trying to recover the losses. Loss is very huge, 5%. Trying to record the losses and prices went to up to 35,000. Again, he has went for long for, he has taken the two lots for long, went for long and put the stop loss at 34,950. So unfortunate prices came hitting his stop losses again. So overall, because of his losing emotions, he's losing to control the emotions, he lost with 7,500. He could have exit with 34,960, that max risk would be the 1,000 rupees. And once hit the stop losses, he is not able to see the charts and randomly he is trading. Initial stage, it happens to me also. So most of the traders, it may happen. Okay. So this is the losing to control the emotions. So this is very, very important in trading psychology. Now, how to control the emotions in live market? So I am suggesting you that, okay, the same scenario. So you fix for do only max two trades in a day. So if it is two trades is completed, shut down your computer. And each trade, set up rules for max risk for trade is 1,000 and reward is 2,000. So these three rules set up in your computer and write it in your notebook. Okay. So I'm not going to trade not more than two trades. You write it down and follow these rules. Okay. If you follow these rules, what is happening day? So there are four scenarios. Okay. First scenario, one win, one lost. So winning is 2,000 and loss trade is minus 1,000. So end of the day, you will be on 1,000 rupees profit. This is scenario one. Scenario two, two trades of lost. What is your max loss of minus 2,000 rupees? This is the 2% of your capital. And third scenario, two wins. So that would be the, you will be get 4,000 rupees of profit. So these three scenarios will happen. In this three scenario, you are not going to lose not more than 2000 rupees. This is a 2%. If you fix these rules, so this is going to happen. Sometimes losing streaks will come 4 to 5 days also. Okay. So maintain and stick the entry and exit target rules. So then only your capital will be grow. And fourth scenario, if you not find any strategies, if you not find any trading opportunities, do nothing, just leave that day. Market will available for tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, or many years. Okay, so don't take any trade without got opportunities. So this is very important in trading psychology. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the strategy. First 5 minutes candle open above the previous day high. Okay, stop loss would be the below that any pivots or below that candle low. Target would be the next pivot level, but candle has to room to move out. So that means, so there is no barriers in this range. Oh, candle has to free to go up. Okay, if you see this candle, this is a previous day high. This yellow line is a previous day high. Candle opening with gap up. First candle is a bullish candle. It took the support from the daily pivot R1 and closes here. In this scenario, you can go for the long and stop loss would be the candle low. Okay. And below pivot low is you are giving one protection, but candle low is a two protection. This pivot has act as a support, and this first 5 minutes candle low acts as a support. So this is a two support of protection, and target would be the next pivot level. So after some 4-5 candles, you reach your target. Okay, and this downside, and this is a narrow CPR. First 5 minutes candle is very big candle. If you see this candle, is very big candle. Okay, our condition is what? Candle should close below the previous day low. This is a previous day low. It closes the previous day low. So second candle is short here, and target is next pivot. What is the stop loss in these cases? In these cases, it's a big candle. You can't put the stop loss above this candle. So you need some protection. Stop loss is the protection. If you see this, this is the previous day low, one protection, and this is the support one, S1. And you can put the stop loss just above the S1. So 50% of this candle. Target would be the next pivot level. So you can easy to get 1:2 risk reward. So always do the micro analysis before going to the entry of any trade. So after that, some prices came to S2 and it came down. Okay. And if you see this third example, first 5 minutes candle, this is a gap down candle and it closes below the previous day low. In this cases, second candle, you can short here. Okay. If it is candle is very big. So if you need one protection, you can put the stop loss above this support one. Or if it is risk reward is matching, then you can take the stop loss from this level above the candle high level. Okay. So you enter here and you exit the trade around S2 level. So this is how price action. This is how this strategy will works. Okay. And if you see this narrow CPR, price is coming from this CPR2 and it closes previous day low. So in this case, second candle, you can go for the short. Okay. Target would be the next pivot level and stop loss. Here also, you will be get two protections. One is the previous day low, second one is the S1. So you can put the stop loss just few points buffer from above this S1. Okay, in between. Okay. So your target would be the S2 level. So you can easy to get 1:2 ratio in this setup. And if you see this, this is a previous day high. Candle open above the previous day high, took the support from the R1. Okay. In these cases, you can go with the second candle. Okay. Stop loss would be the below the R1 or first 5 minutes candle low. If it is risk reward is matching, then you can put the stop loss first 5 minutes candle low, or you can put the stop loss below the R1 level, target would be the R2. So same thing is happened. Okay. And this is a narrow CPR. Again, this big bearish candle. Okay. And second candle, you can go for the short. Why? Because this is the previous day low and this is the S1. Okay. And target would be the S2 level. Okay. You can go short here and put the stop loss above this S1 level, target would be the S2 level. And if you find this narrow CPR and if you can flat with this 8 EMA. So 8 EMA always is rejected from the price. We see this rejection, 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 rejection. Okay. So narrow CPR is we consider as a trending day. So trending days you can trail with your trade with 8 EMA. And here also gap down opening. Okay. You can go short for this second candle and stop loss is above this candle, but here is tricky. See, this S3 to S4 is gap is very less. We see this gap is very less. If you go short second candle, you may not reach risk reward would not be matched. So these cases wait for the retracement. Okay. Once you see this bearish engulf candle, bearish candle, so you can go for the short and stop loss above this recent high. This is a recent high and target would be the S4 level. And if you have confidence on trade, you can trail with this 8 EMA. So price is respecting for 8 EMA. You see this. So once closes above 8 EMA, you can exit the trade. Okay. And here is price is opening above the previous day high. But tricky is that if you see this wick, this is the R1 support one. Wick is there and second candle is fill that wick. This wick and above is close the second candle. So in these cases, we can go for the long. This is a bullish momentum, but some rejection after that, this second candle has filled that wick. You can go long for the third candle. Stop loss would be the second candle or first candle low, target would be the R2 level. And if you see this 20 EMA and here also 8 EMA support. And if you find this type of big candle, so try to avoid. Why? Because if you see this is a previous day high, this is the R1. This is a big candle. This is R1 to R2 candle. So one candle is big length candle. If you and here also first candle is not broken and second candle is went up this level. So in this type of big candle, so try to avoid the trade. Why? Because you may not get this good reward. Okay, risk is very high, so reward is very less. So always check with the risk and reward, then only you can go for the trade. So after that, this is a supply zone, prices came and finally it took the support at CPR level. Okay. So try to avoid this type of trades. And here also, if you see this first 5 minutes candle open above this R1 level and this bullish candle. And always you check this Nifty level also. Why this type of zigzag? Because of Nifty and Bank Nifty, most of the time is tandem. Nifty follows the Bank Nifty follows the Nifty. Check with the both the charts, then only you can enter the trade. So otherwise, this type of trades, you may hit your stop losses frequently. Okay. Check with the both and you can enter it. And finally, conclusion of these things. This 20% of the success on strategy. So what does that mean? Strategy will give the direction, not for the profitable. Okay. Profitable coming on risk management and trading psychology. Okay, 30% of the success depending on risk management and 50% of the success depending on trading psychology. This is only 20% of the strategy and 80% of the depending on you. So how to control your emotion in live market and how to take exact entry and exit and target rules. So then only success will come. So 80% of the time depending on you. Not for the strategy. Okay. That's it for today. So I'm conducting advanced price action and future options webinars also. So totally I'm having this 15 time tested strategies, that's 2 years back tested strategies. So market is always may not go one direction. Market is going upside, downside and sideways. So the three type of ways market is movement will be there. So based on that moment, we have this 15 strategies. Not only for that, even gap up opening, we have strategies and gap down opening strategies. In between breakout, also we have some strategies. And a few of the options are strategies also available for this working professionals. So if you want interest and you can call me to 9700850968. You can SMS me or you can contact to me ashok.bomara@gmail.com. So that's it for today and I hope you're enjoying this video. So I will come many strategies in future and don't forget to subscribe the channel and kindly like it and kindly share your comment. And if it is having any trading friends or community, kindly post in this video to trading community. And this channel is 100% giving for this knowledge, transferring knowledge to retail traders or novice traders. So that's it for today. So happy weekend to all and signing off.